Hello everyone, this is Dipali Pathak here, and today I am going to discuss with you the mechanism of breathing in human being that we have to study in detail. In previous lecture, we have studied about the respiration in human being and respiratory system. Mechanism is a process which is complete in three steps, that is the inhalation, exchange of gases and exhalation. So that we are going to discuss in detail. Students, human being taking oxygen from the atmosphere, that process is called as inhalation. During the mechanism, we call it inspiration. Means intake of oxygen is inspiration and releasing out the carbon dioxide, that is called as expiration. In between these two steps, one more important steps come, that is the exchange of gases, which takes place in between the blood and the alveoli. So, in this picture you can see the position of lungs, which is protected by the rib cage, the chest cavity. One pair of lung is there, which is covered in pleural membrane. This red structure is lung. These are surrounded by pleural membrane around it, and in front, chest bone is there, which is called as sternum. Sternum is there. With sternum, both the side ribs are attached. Ribs are flattened, elongated bones which are attached with sternum in front, and at the back they are attached with the backbone. So together these all structure make rib cage, which is a cage like structure. These bones are associated with each other with the help of intercostal muscles. These intercostal muscles are very important, which help the ribs to rise or come down during the breathing. A flat long bone below the rib cage, that is called as diaphragm. Mechanism of breathing is the process in which the inspiration, expiration and exchange of gases takes place in a proper sequence that we are going to discuss. First step, that is inspiration, then exchange of gases, and last one is the expiration. In the next picture you can see it's a cavity in the lung. Suppose this is a lung and this is cavity inside it. Then diaphragm, a flat bone is there below the rib cage. These are the ribs. When inspiration means intake of oxygen occurs, then these intercostal muscles help to lift the bone, or this rib cage means ribs are raised upward in this way. They are raised upward and the diaphragm become lower and become flattened and increase the capacity of lung to feel oxygen. So this all takes place during the inspiration. During this, the air enters through the nostril and pass from the nasal passage and then conveyed through the trachea into the lungs, and then it feeds into the alveolar sacs. Then exchange of gases takes place. The process takes place inside the alveoli. Suppose this is an alveoli. Alveolar sac, when filled with oxygen, it is surrounded by blood capillaries, and here the carbon dioxide and oxygen exchange. Means the oxygen is taken up by blood from alveoli to blood vessel, takes place here in the alveoli. Then blood releases carbon dioxide into the alveoli that it brings from the whole body. Now from these blood capillaries, RBCs, which are present in blood capillaries in the form of blood cells, consist of hemoglobin, which is a respiratory pigment in the blood, take up the oxygen and carries it to the tissues which are deficient in the oxygen. Then the next step of the process is oxygen is then transported to all the cells in the body by respiratory pigments such as hemoglobin, and due to diffusion pressure it happens. Then the next process, next and the last process, is expiration. Expiration means giving out the carbon dioxide from the body. During expiration, again the accessory organ had to work along with the lungs. During expiration, the ribs are lifted, ribcage relaxed, and diaphragm move upward. You can see here in the diagram, the arrow shows the upward movement of the diaphragm. Diaphragm relaxed and raised and become dome shaped. During that, ribs lowered and it decreased the capacity of lungs, due to which lungs are pushed and the carbon dioxide move away through the nostrils. So in this way, in three steps, inspiration, exchange of gases, and completes in higher animals such as human being. Then let's come to understand the respiratory surfaces in other animals. Several respiratory surfaces in different animals, they have evolved different organs for performing this activity. Different surfaces such as cell membrane, moist skin, spiracles, gills, and lungs in higher animals. These are the different organs or different body parts through which organism perform their respiration. These all surfaces which are used for the respiration have some specific characters, such as the respiratory surface should be thin walled. Suppose the respiratory surface is cell membrane or the gills, then it should be thin walled and it should be highly vascularized, means it is richly supplied with the blood capillaries so that the exchange of gases may take place easily. So first character of it, that it should be thin walled. Then the surface of gaseous exchange must be moist to speed up the diffusion. Third character of the surface, that it should be large in its area and it should be richly supplied with the blood. So first we will discuss the respiratory surface in unicellular organisms such as amoeba and some flatworms such as planaria. Amoeba, planaria, these are the unicellular microscopic organism and they can exchange the gases through diffusion, and the medium and the surface in them is their body wall. Suppose this is the body of an amoeba. So plasma membrane is the outermost covering of their body. Through the diffusion, small molecules of the oxygen and carbon dioxide cross the plasma membrane and exchange takes place. So the diffusion is method in amoeba and planaria. Then the moist skin, it is used by earthworm and leeches, which are the member of any. So earthworm breathe through their moist skin, and this skin are moist and richly supplied with blood capillaries. These blood capillaries are very close to their skin, through which the gaseous exchange takes place. Easily the molecule of oxygen and carbon dioxide diffused, oxygen enter into the blood capillaries, which is very close to the skin, and the carbon dioxide diffuses out into the atmosphere. The skin is very slimy and moist due to the secretion of its own, and the respiration through the skin is called as cutaneous respiration. So here the respiratory surface is its whole body. Next is the spiracles. Spiracles are tiny pores, small hole-like structure which are present in some insects such as grasshopper and mosquitoes. This organism have air tube and small hole-like structure near the body surface at both the laterals, which are connected with each other with a common tube, which is called as trachea or air tube. In this way, the air enter into the body. They have the hemocele, where the exchange of gases takes place. These small pores are called as spiracles, and the air tube which connect them is called as trachea. So with the help of spiracle and trachea, the gaseous exchange takes place in cockroaches and mosquitoes and in house flies too. Next thing, that is the gills. Gills are present in aquatic animals such as fishes. Student, the respiration is faster in aquatic animal than the terrestrial animal because the amount of dissolved oxygen is less than the air. So they have to breathe fast, rapidly to accumulate the air in their body for getting energy. So gills are the structure in aquatic animal. Suppose this is a fish. Gill record is there. Gills are the thin skin folds which are richly supplied with the blood capillaries. When water entered into the body through the mouth, it passes from the gills, and during that the gases exchange takes place. This is the water current. When it enters into the mouth, through mouth, it passes over the gills and then mix with the water body. During that, the carbon dioxide is released out, and the oxygen of the water which is dissolved in it is mixed in the blood capillaries. So gills are used by the aquatic animals. Here a very important question is for you, that is, why the respiration is faster in aquatic animals than the terrestrial animal? So the answer is, dissolved amount of oxygen in its water is less than the air. Then lungs are present in higher animals such as birds and mammals. In birds, air sacs are also there, which help in the storage of lot of the air during the flight. So with the help of lungs and air sac, bird can breathe. And in higher animals such as human being have well developed respiratory system through which they can exchange the gases for getting energy. Then the next topic is how respiration takes place in plants. So in plants, almost exchange of gases takes by stomata, which are present in the basal surface of. Suppose this is leaf of any plant in which the stomata are present in the epidermis layer. Mostly these are present in the lower surface. This is the stomatal pore. Plant ensure that each cell and stomata remain in contact with the air. It should be exposed so that the exchange may take place easily. So with the help of this stomata, gaseous exchange takes place in the plant.
Plant respire in different way during the different time of the day. The exchange of gases is different during the daytime and it changes during the night. See here in the diagram, during the daytime when sunlight is present, when sunlight is bright, the carbon dioxide enters through the stomata and it is utilized for the photosynthesis and oxygen is released as a waste product or as a byproduct. But it reverses during the night. During the night time, the sunlight is absent and no photosynthesis takes place. That is why the carbon dioxide is eliminated, because the breakdown of glucose takes place for obtaining the energy in the plant body. So it is different in daytime. During daytime they release the oxygen and take the carbon dioxide, but it reverses during the night. Means during the night time the carbon dioxide is released out and the oxygen is absorbed. So in this way, through the stomata, gaseous exchange takes place in plant, in which the leaves help. Some other parts are also there. Roots also help in the exchange of gases. In muddy area, when the roots are submerged into the mud or in the soil, in soil particle air is present, which is diffused and enter into the plant body. So roots also help in the gaseous exchange through the diffusion. Then lenticels are also present in some plants. Lenticels are small pore-like structure through which the gaseous exchange takes place. So stomata, root hairs at the stem, different parts of the plant help in gaseous exchange. Then respiratory pigment, which is very important component of the blood, which carry the oxygen in higher animals. There are different type of respiratory pigment in organisms such as hemoglobin, hemoerythrin, hemocyanin, vanadium. These all are the respiratory pigment. Means when gaseous exchange takes place during the breathing, the inhaled oxygen is carried away to the tissues by this respiratory pigment. Among these, the hemoglobin is very common, which is widely used by the organism. The metal base for it is the iron. It provides the red color to the blood. Its metallic part, hemoglobin, the heme, is a non-proteinous and the globin is a proteinous part of it. In the presence of iron, when it combines with the RBC, it provides red color to it and it has the great affinity with the oxygen. So it combines with the oxygen and carry it to the tissues. Only the diffusion pressure alone cannot take care of oxygen delivery to all the body parts in large size animal. So the respiratory pigment such as hemoglobin take up oxygen from the air in the lungs and carry it to the tissues.